Today, you'll learn how to insert charts into your slides in a presentation. Charts provide a visual representation of your numeric data. To insert a chart, head straight to the slide where you want the chart to appear. In the center here, you'll see quick options. For example, you can insert a picture, you can insert smart art, you can insert 3D models, insert a video, insert a table. The last option here is insert a chart. So you can click this one, or you can head to the menu bar and then you click insert and look for chart. Click chart. You'll see the different types of charts available in PowerPoint. The commonest that we use are the column chart, the line chart, pie chart, bar graph, and area graphs. Now, when you click on any of these graphs, PowerPoint will provide for you the different types under that kind of chart. For example, when I click on column, I can see the first section here is clustered, the next one is stacked, and so on. You can check out all of them. When you click on line, you will see the first category, the second category, the third, and so on. So the pie, you see the first one, yeah? The second one is 3D pie, the third one is pie of pie, and so on. So choose the one you want, choose the category under the graph which you have chosen, and then click OK. PowerPoint immediately launches for you an Excel sheet in which you can enter the data for you to generate the graph. But it already has some default values which are being used to create this default chart, which is like a guide to you. So you just replace this data here. For example, I want to look at sales of milk and bananas in the first quarter of 2024. The first quarter has January, has February, it has March. That is the first quarter. If you also observe, you realize that there is this blue boundary which is appearing here. The data that appears on the chart is that is within the boundary here. So I don't need this because I only wanted the first quarter, so I can delete it. And then bananas. We don't need this column because we only have milk and bananas, so we can delete it. But if you had other items like say soya, eggs, we have milk, we have bananas, we have soya, but eggs are not appearing because eggs are outside this small rectangle. So we highlight it like I've done. And when you highlight it, it extends to include eggs. But you realize also that eggs doesn't have values, the default values, because it was outside the table. We can go ahead to enter the data. For example, if milk was 2,500 liters, you see that the graph immediately changed. 2,300 liters, and then in March, 2,450. Each time you enter data here, the graph updates automatically. Bananas, 1,200 bunches, 2,000 in February, 1,500. Maybe now this one is in kilograms. So yeah, in kilograms, you produced 800. Next was 950. And next reduced to 700 kilograms. Eggs in trays, you produced 1,500, 3,000. After that, simply close the Excel sheet here. You will see your chart right here. That's how we insert the charts. Now, every chart, of course, requires certain basic details, like the title is maybe a chart representing sales of milk, bananas, soya, and eggs. So you have that chart title. You see on the side here, you have these quick options here, chart elements, you have chart style, and then you have chart filters. When you want to change or to add chart elements, you just click the plus. You have the axis, you have the title, the axis titles, you have data labels, and so on. So it's upon you to choose. Now I have clicked on axis titles, so I can label the vertical axis, maybe amount produced by the farm, and then on the horizontal axis, month. Your chart is now complete. It has all labels it requires. Now, usually when I'm presenting to a large audience, I prefer to put labels to these bars which are appearing in the chart for easy interpretation. So just click on plus, and then add data labels. It's automatic. When you click on data labels, you'll see your values attached to the bars. So the audience will know clearly that this is 2,500, this is 1,200, 800, and then 1,000, and so on, instead of having to guess or to estimate. The legend is actually the key. This one which you're seeing down, milk, bananas, soya, and eggs. So you can also make adjustments on where you want to place the legend. Do you want it at the right side? Yes, you see, even before I clicked, it has been pushed to the right. Okay, let me click so that we experience the change. Okay, so when I clicked right, now the legend has been moved from the bottom to the right. That's how you can insert charts. When you click on this chart here, and then you go to chart design, you can design the chart. See here, you can make changes and format your chart to look the way you want. See, I'm not clicking there, but let me try to click this one, which gives it a background so that you experience what I'm talking about. Yes, when I click it, see that? That is a design that you could choose. When you click inside the chart here is when you can see the chart design tools appearing. Okay, I can put this dark background of the to the chart so that it is more visible to my audience. But I think the first one was more clear. Please, you can go ahead to try these several designs for you to choose the one which best fits you, your audience, whenever you're providing such charts. Click here to see the data that is generating that graph. You can see when you click select data, it quickly brings you to the Excel sheet and particularly to the data which is producing that chart. Close it. You can also edit the data. It will still take you to the Excel sheet where you can edit data. My interest for now is here. Change chart type. If you, for example, created a column graph like you did here, and now you realize that you didn't need a column chart, but you needed a bar chart, you just click here, go to chart design, and then change chart type. It brings you back here, and you simply click the appropriate chart that you wanted, that you needed to create, and then you click OK. Yeah, just converts that chart immediately into the chart that you want to change to. You can still change it to a line chart if you want. There are different categories of line charts, so choose the one you want. Okay, click OK. So you can switch between the charts the way you want. You can now play with the other remaining options. If you went to just change the data, for example, edit data here, and then you change anything, the chart will update automatically.
That's it.
If you've learned how to insert charts into your presentation, please like this video, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell so that each time I publish such a video, you're the first to be notified. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one. I will sing.